What could possibly be going through the mind of someone willing to kill their own children? Well, we have some special insight tonight. Fox 2's Jeff Bernthal interviewed one woman who has the answer in this in-depth interview. Jeff.
Well, Mandy, Dr. Diane Sanford has interviewed women who have murdered their children and then failed at killing themselves. She talked with us about how someone could even think about killing their own flesh and blood.
Three cases all within a year, all within the St. Louis area. In March, a Baldwin mother kills her children and then takes her own life. In July, the Glendale tragedy, and now in Jefferson County.
No one is safe from this. This cuts across cultural boundaries. This cuts across race, socioeconomic status. Everybody has some vulnerability to a mental health episode.
Dr. Diane Sanford says sadly these tragedies are nothing new. In fact, she was interviewed 21 years ago for a magazine article about moms killing their children in 1991. She's written several books and has interviewed women who have killed their children and then failed in a suicide attempt.
These episodes occur because these women are convinced that they and their children will truly be in a better place, dead rather than alive.
Sanford says untreated mental illness can lead to an unstoppable psychosis that leads to loving mothers becoming murderers.
These women are not villains. They are not any different than you or I. However, they are extremely mentally ill, and they didn't get the treatment and support they needed to prevent these tragedies from occurring.
In all three St. Louis area tragedies, the mothers used guns. Sanford says that's unusual, but not surprising.
Women more often give the babies pills, give the children pills, lay down to sleep with them. So guns are unusual, but what we know about guns is they take care of the job. No problems later.
She hopes these tragedies are more than a wake-up call for a greater awareness about mental illness. She hopes it's also a wake-up call to make sure victims receive treatment.
And warning signs to look for include if someone just doesn't seem to be themselves, if they're having a lot of stress or anxiety or frequent mood changes. We have a link to resources for help at fox2now.com. Jeff Bernthal, Fox 2 News. One person.